Okay, this is Mead and Moz coming back at you. Like I said, I would do a second video after all the parts have been reinstalled. New brass precision gears, replaced the plastic, and there is the new encoder. I want you to see it before I put the housing cover back on it. RA control board assembled back to the base. And also, you'll notice that they only put two screws on it from the factory. Each one of these points here is a ground point. So I always put the remainder two screws that are missing in place. And normally, these are cap head screws. I remove them. And they install the small button head screws. These little tiny guys right here. And they actually can tend to strip out if you ever had to service it. So I replaced those with the cap head screws. I'll be putting four on the boards, and all the boards throughout the scope are like that. So again, I always put in the extra screws to be sure that that doesn't cause a ground fault, which it could. If all the ground points are not properly secured, that could be a potential ground fault, and that could be one of the reasons why Mead has so many issues with their scopes from time to time. So I tend to go over and beyond the call of duty when I service these scopes and be sure that everything is precisely back in place and done properly, even better than what the techs do at Mead. That's just what I do. Originally, on the LX200 GPS scopes, the wiring comes out here, loops around, has a wire tie here, then they go up, so you see all the wires here. So potentially, it can get sandwiched on the bottom plate right here at this point, or possibly here. In the R, if you notice, they actually tuck the wires under the board and bring them out here. So whenever I service these scopes, that's what I do. I do the same process that they did in the R, because it looks better, it's neater looking. And it gets them out of the way. So this here plug here is for your encoder board. So we'll go ahead for your encoder there, and we will go ahead and plug that guy in. And it only fits one way, so you got to figure out which way it goes. I believe that's the correct way. Okay, there we go. Okay, that is in. Kind of get these wires out of the way, like that. And then we'll go ahead and put the top cap on. That just clips in place with those ears that I talked about in the first video with the spacer to install the encoder with. Those are the ears that lock this cap into place. Okay, that's one side. Okay. Here it's snapping into place. That is it. There we go. Okay. They're securely locked on the ears, and that's what it looks like after the installation is complete. And again, with the worm drive, here is the small little Allen screw they installed. Again, it's black powder. I changed everything to stainless. And there's the adjustment screw there, the new one. And that is a number 6 32nd by 3/4. And I also do the upgrade kits for the screws as well. I have kits for those, for the LX200 GPS and for the R. They actually have two different style screws. And again, back here, the screws that hold the worm drive to the base, or black powder. I changed those out to stainless. And on the adjustment, you can actually adjust this with your hand now. I actually will put a little bit of a blue Loctite on when I'm finished. Made from the factory. Not quite that loose. Let's see. Trying to get it to about where they have it from the factory. That's probably close. That's about how loose it is from the factory. And you just don't want it that loose. That's just way too sloppy. So you adjust your set screw so that you can only move it ever so slightly. That's about it right there. Somewhere in that range. Maybe just a hair tighter than that. That's about it right there. And you can see the worm drive at the bottom there. So that's about how much end play you want in that gear there. Not much at all. Not as sloppy as they make it from the factory. Okay, now we're going to start with the wires coming out of the base. Well, the large one is what powers everything. That one goes, everything is kind of self-explanatory. The longer pin there, that's where that goes. And they only go in one direction. So you can't get that wrong. And that clips into place there. And this one here with the blue plug, that goes to your batteries. That is your power supply for your batteries. If you are one of the more experienced telescope users who do not use batteries and use an external power supply, this you can actually just go ahead and unplug it and get it out of the way, if you will, because you remove the battery packs out of the forearms anyway, so you don't use it. So that's what I've done. I just unplugged it from mine and I just fold it back and I just tucked it out of the way just because it's not being used anymore. The black one here, this one here actually stays plugged in. That actually works the power switch on the main motherboard. So that one does stay in. That one you want to make sure that does stay plugged in. And the one closest, the plug closest to the frame there, to the base, is for the batteries. And we'll plug that back in. Actually move that, get that out of the way. So we can work on that. And then go ahead and put the switch plug back in. Okay, now the other wire coming out of the base, this one here goes to the fork arm. And that one goes over here. That goes to the fork arm. And the other last wire that has the electromagnetic interference coil on it, that one comes off of the RA board. That one goes here. That's the one that controls your RA. And that goes there. Now, generally what I will do is I'll take a blue Sharpie and I will mark this side of the plug and this side of the port here in line. Although this kind of, you know, makes it a no-brainer. You know where that goes because this is on the RA drive. But still, I will normally take a blue Sharpie and mark this part of the plug. And on the blue one, I will mark the opposite side on the motherboard and on the plug so that I know that this one goes there and that one goes there. So it's just good practice sometimes, especially if you're not used to working on these. it's just a good thing to do so that you don't get them wrong. Because these two plugs are the exact same color code and the exact same size plug, so they both do fit on each one of these ports. So you can potentially forget that this one goes there and put it over here. It really won't hurt nothing. You'll just basically be running the scope in reverse when you use your controls. So it won't be a big deal. You can just swap them back over. Okay. Then we will go ahead and organize them a little bit and put a wire tie on it. And you can actually pull a little bit of slack out of here. There's plenty of slack in there. And then you can actually move these wires anywhere you want. And put a nice little wire tie on them and keep them out of the way. And also, I forgot to mention in the first video, Meade puts hot glue on their plugs and on the negative and positive to the wire to the motor. I removed that in the beginning. It does not have to go back on. They only do it so that, you know, it makes you look like that you can't take it apart when you can. So that really does not need to be hot glued back together. And again, your home sensor. This is basically two identical plugs and they're just hot glued together. And I actually saw a comment where someone had taken theirs apart and got confused on where these go. It does not matter. Both of these single plugs are wired identically. As you can see, it's black, red, and yellow. And then over here, it looks like it's reversed. But if I flip it over, it's the same. Black, red, yellow, black, red, yellow. So they're both pinned out exactly the same. So it doesn't matter, you know, which one you use. They both, you know, work in the same fashion. And again, there was grease on the eye readers. I cleaned those off. And when you install these, be sure and keep the wiring out of the way first so you can get in there. Tuck that back there. Okay. Now the home sensor goes here. There's two small screws. Again, they're button head screws, and I will change them out to cap head screws. Okay. Now you will see that the screw holes are oblonged. You basically want to put the screw so that you can slide this bracket all the way up like this. So you want that screw to match where it was before. You can see the mark where the screws were. You don't want it down here. You want it up here like that. Okay, that's a good starting point. And then just gingerly just snug them ever so slightly. And then once you're done, you will take the encoder wheel like I showed you earlier. And you will move this by hand. Okay. And these two screws right here, there's a block attached on the other side of that. Okay. And you'll need a small flashlight so that you can see in there. And basically you're going to want to rotate that wheel, the encoder wheel, until these two screws disappear. Disappear behind the base like that. So that block right there is going to pass in between those eye readers. You do not want it to hit that. So if you have to adjust this a little bit down or a little bit up, you basically want those eye readers to be as close as possible to that block behind there without hitting it. And that's how you adjust it. You want that eye reader to be as close as possible without bumping or hitting anything. And I've actually uninstalled them and seen one of the eye readers completely bent all the way back and touching the board because that block behind there smacked into it and pushed it back. And the problem with that is if you try and straighten it out, those pins are so sensitive you can actually break that eye reader off the board, and which I've done that before. And as being, you know, as gingerly as possible, it still happened. So if you ever have that issue, by all means, please try and stand that thing up as carefully as possible. And I've had a few where I've straightened them out, no problem. I've probably only had one out of five that broke off on me. But I've got parts on hand, so it's not too much of a big deal. If it breaks, I got another one. So that's pretty much how that works. Again, this is Meade Mods with the Meade LX200 GPS 8-inch. Sent from Goddard Space Flight Center for repairs. And there is their government sticker that they put on their scopes. I actually have two of them. One there and one there. So, so again, please leave a comment if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer any questions you may have. And I will be doing the declination on the next video. And also my clutch lock knobs that I have. Thank you. And I hope this helps.